First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Ghanshyam Kalathia for taking this wonderful initiative of starting this basic course of repertory for the body as well as practicing homeopathy. As I know him since my college days, in any given topics, he goes into its depth. This inquisitiveness has led him to write many books and conducts many seminars for providing deeper understanding of our science. And I'm lucky that I got the opportunity to witness his journey as we were classmates and roommates. And I can see his creativity is blooming as the time passes. And in this journey of repertory, you are also experiencing it. So now what is repertory? If we see from the practical aspect, in my own experience, and the experience of successful cases of my colleagues and assistants, I have found again and again that the number of cases cured by any homeopath increase by the use of the repertory. Here I am not talking like that the materia medica is not useful. There is one very strange thing, as I am a teacher of materia medica, but still I insist more on repertory to practice homeopathy. Even the old masters down from Hanuman, who had such in-depth knowledge of materia medica, felt the need for repertory to find the most suitable remedy. The reason why we need repertory, that it acts as a tool, and a tool always makes you work qualitative. By the help of repertory, we evaluate and understand symptoms much better. The more deeper and better you understand each symptom, the better you find the medicine of the case. Here we will learn about the basic fundamental use of repertory and how to analyze a case or a symptom in the form of rubric. I am not going to advise you about the selection of repertory at this stage because this is basic course. And what I feel, we shall learn as much as we can about the interpretation of different rubrics and their live expression in any given cases. So let's start with the journey of rubrics, practical application of rubrics. Here I am going to show you the rubrics which I use in my practice and I got wonderful results. From my perspective, practical perspective, I divided repertory in two parts. Here you find those rubrics which give us an aerial view of a symptom. And there are rubrics which give you us a microscopic view on any symptoms. See, aerial view means these are the rubrics which express the general pattern in the patient's symptom or the common hereditary pattern. And microscopic view refer to those rubrics which are individualizing, providing peculiar detail of one symptom which form a single complete symptoms, what we can say PQRS. Now I have a very interesting case. While asking whether patient likes any covering or not, the patient gives this expression that in any season she covers her whole body but keeps her feet uncovered. Even in winter she covers until the ankles and keeps her feet out of the blanket. So here if you see the rubric, extremities, feet inclination to uncover. So it is in extremities. Here the second rubric, in many patients you find because of burning pain they keep their feet uncover. So the rubrics in extremities, pain, burning, smarting, inclination to uncover feet. Now in many female patients the such symptoms you find in climacteric age. The same section you find the rubrics feet uncover inclination to in climatic period. Only sanguinaria is medicine. So repertory is like a hidden trigger. If you know the repertory, what happens? Many a times while studying a drug in materia medica, we are unaware of certain aspect of the drug, which comes as a surprise when we find them in the repertory. I had a very interesting case. For example, there is a case of hair fall. I changed 2 to 3 medicine, but without any effect. So I ask further details, and patient has also complained of vertigo. On asking, when does he feel giddy? He said, whenever he sees any moving object like vehicles passing by in speed, he feels dizzy and nauseating at the same time. So these symptoms are something uncommon for me. So I search in repertory and I got two rubrics. Vertigo by looking at moving objects and nausea by looking at moving objects. When I repertorized these two rubrics, very interesting thing, the medicine came are jaborandi, coculus and pilocarpus. So when you know, most of you know that jaborandi is medicine for hair falling. Generally we think of coculus only, but here jaborandi covers both rubrics in highest grade, and jaborandi is a prominent medicine for hair falling. So when you open the Clark Materia Medica, in jaborandi it is mentioned that jaborandi has been used as a remedy for baldness, and it forms the principal ingredients in some of the popular hair restorer. In a number of patients who have been taking it, white hair and blonde hair have been observed to turn black. Let's we take the next example. Any symptoms, be it fever, coryza, pain, vertigo, when there is a sudden onset, like 15 minutes ago, patient was completely normal and active, and in the next 15 minutes, he feel malaise. On measuring temperature, it was already 100 Fahrenheit. Within 5 minutes, it shot up to the 102, then followed by normal temperature within next 15 minutes. But this is without any apparent cause or medicines. So here, you find the symptoms are appearing and disappearing suddenly. Generally in repertory, we have pain appear and disappear suddenly. But here's the typical symptoms which appear and disappear suddenly. So in general, it is very interesting rubric. Manifestation, sudden, coming and going. Now the same rubrics you can apply it any of the symptoms like migraine, coryza, vertigo, fever, and many more condition like this. So the lesson is, the eye sees only what the mind knows. If we know of these rubrics, then only we can apply in the practice. Another very interesting case, I had a case of pain in legs since 5 years. On inquiring, there was one interesting symptom. Patient said she had pain in eyes whenever there was pain in legs. So it is very interesting symptom, because there is no relation between eye and leg. But I search in the repertory, and in Boni Hussein, under the eye section, I find the exact symptoms. Eye pain aggravation when there is a pain in other parts during. I took this one rubric and two or three other rubrics, and I prescribe arsenical. And with my surprise, that pain was vanished completely within 1 month, which was previously since 3 years. Another example, generally we find nausea is from the pit of stomach, but a patient described that I feel nausea is originating from throat. So when you know such rubric exists in repertory, you can use it when patient gives the exact expression. So you find in throat section nausea from throat, the same way you find nausea from chest. So from next time, once you know this type of rubrics, so any patient of nausea, your case taking become more precise. You go into the depth of the symptom. Okay, tell me from where you feel the nausea. In patient of convulsion on spasm, when we find history of convulsion in the family, strong history of migraine or other neuralgic pain in the family tree, so it is the hereditary constitution which makes them prone to this type of illness. Generally, we are only considering what are the types of convulsion, where you find aggravation, amelioration. But when you go to the past history or the family history, you find more than 5 or 6 members of the family suffering from the same disease or the same this neurological conditions. So very interesting rubric. In general, it is constitution, neuropathy. You can consider this rubric when you find the strong family history of this type of neurological disease. In many females, we find much hair over face, upper lip. This is an observational rubric. You observe the patient and you get this medicine. So here the rubric is hair on unusual parts. Now the same things you find in females. This hair growth over extremities, which is very thick in texture like that of male. So here you have rubric hair parts unusual in masculine women, strong constitution. There is another case, patient had a cough with expectoration. When I asked about expectoration, he said it was difficult to bring out. He had to cough out of mucus with much effort from the back of the nose. So patient consciously doing that, so this hawking. So very interesting thing, if you see this picture, anatomical picture, this is nasopharynx. Here there is a mucus and that mucus lead to constant irritation. So patient constantly hawking. So we have very interesting rubric in throat, mucus from posterior nose hawking. So you can use this rubric. Another case, a teenager boy came to me for acute complaint of vomiting. On asking him, vomiting had started as the exam were arriving. I asked what he felt before exam. He said he had worries about his performance, difficulty level of questions, whether he will finish it on time. In short, there is anticipation about exams. Very interesting. The boy said vomiting also starts when he gets angry about something or is extremely tense. So here, every time vomiting starts after excitation of emotions. And we have rubrics in stomach, vomiting from emotions. When patient present the complaint that whenever he has much hectic work at office, which require him a lot of mental exercise, and that day he has gastric upset. So here you have rubric in stomach, indigestion after mental exertion. A patient who had a complaint of severe abdominal pain due to taking some junk food gave this expression that he wants to vomit it out to get relief from the heaviness and pain, but he is unable to. If only he could vomit, he will be relieved. So here you have rubric vomiting desire to but cannot. I had a case of child who had tendency to easily vomit whenever she jumped, laughed or did any physical exertion. So here the rubric is vomiting easy. In one case of renal colic, patient had severe pain in right lumbar region. When I saw the report, the renal stone was in left kidney. But there was no pain on that side. Every time he had pain in right lumbar region. So here you can thought of the same pathology is on right side and pain is on the left side. So here you have rubric in generalities, pain, neuralgic, synalgia. The synalgia means it is referred or reflex pain felt in a part distance from the site of its origin. I had a case of chronic rhinitis. Then patient narrated a very interesting subjective symptom. She feels that the dusty environment everywhere, even inside the house, where not even slight dust is present. Her daughter explained that when all of us are sitting in the living room having completely clear air, she asks us, don't you all feel there is dust around us in the room? Patient said, I feel it so much as if it's actually inside my nose, which makes me feel so everywhere I go. That's the subjectivity of the patient. Thus the rubric is dust sensation of internal part. And this rubric you find in general section. Generalities, dust sensation of internal part. Now let's those who are beginners those who are interns, I would say that you start with the each and every section of the repertory. Let's see, study one rubric that we generally find what happened before menses. Here I have some PowerPoint slides from the repertory. Here you see that first slide, vertigo before menses. Now just listen and observe this rubric. The next slide, palpitation before menses. Third slide, hearing impaired before menses. Cough before menses. Coryza before menses. Urine burning before menses. Photophobia during menses. Invision dim before menses. Hemorrhoids before menses. Nausea before menses. So now from this all the rubrics, we find here there are so many concomitants to menses. Previously we only used to ask about abdominal pain, back pain or irritability during, before or after menses. But here you see that after going through this rubrics, the next time you start a case of female patient, your question will increase regarding symptoms before, during or after menses. So in this way, your case taking will become more deeper and precise. So it's like a counter inquiry. When you ask the patient about menstrual history, it just explains you about the periods, location and whatever the pain. And after that, when you probe the symptoms, it is known as counter inquiry. Now it's your turn. So you ask, is there anything happened before menses like vomiting, dim vision? So many times you get the hint. So now by this way, it can make you more deeper in your case taking. At last, I would like to say that let us all grow together. Promote and conduct more and more group discussion sessions by which you will get more knowledge in less time. By this way, it will be a very qualitative discussion giving to understanding of each rubric, not just to the reader, but to the rest of the group. This way, there will be collective growth. Allot a topic to each member. See, this is my personal experience. If you have a group of more than 10 doctors, students, interns, you should allot the topics. Then he or she must thoroughly study it and then explain how to visualize the rubric or what will be the patient's expression for such rubric. So by taking that symptom, by understanding that discussion, your knowledge become more deeper. And as I see, I really heartily congratulate to my friend Ghanshyam and his entire team, because since last 20 days, I see each and every member of this group is very active. And that active participants is only because of the priceless effort of Ghanshyam. Because it is very difficult to give the answer to each and every student. And there is something different of this course that I would like to share with you, that in most of the seminars or the repertory or whatever the seminars, you just sit and attend the seminars. That's it. Then you come to your clinics and you start your practicing. But what I see last 20 days, for 30 days, that it is give you more exercise. When you search for the rubrics, you also go through the different possible rubrics. So in that way, your understanding is become more broader. And this is the only way. And I say this is a really a practical seminar. What I can say, it is a workshop. Many of us, we are not knowing each other. We are not connected to each other, but we are connected by the only one person, the dynamic personality is Ghanshyam Kalathia. So again, I thanks to my dear friend Ghanshyam Kalathia. See, this is my practical application of repertory, how the rubrics are important in cases. If you have any query, then you can contact me or WhatsApp me on my mobile number, or you can mail me on my Gmail. Thank you very much. Thank you.